cancer survival rates have improved very significantly in many countries over the last decade, principally because of much better chemotherapy. But many of those chemotherapies have appalling side effects. So what we need urgently are powerful forms of chemo which can be targeted to the individual cell without affecting healthy cells. Scientists working in the laboratory have been able to engineer a human virus which only infects cancer cells. It exploits a particular weakness of every cancer cell that we've studied so far that produces tumors and does not have the capacity to infect normal tissue. The side effects seem to be minimal in human trials so far. The commonest is a slight flu-like illness for 24 hours, but only a minority of people even seem to have that. So it's essentially a treatment without serious side effects. We've been able to load an additional instruction inside these virus particles so that the cells that they infect are taught not only to make new virus particles, but also to make chemotherapy. You say, well, how can that be? You see, scientists have created a molecule. It's called a prodrug because it's not an active drug itself. It's a drug that's protected in the blood. It doesn't actually have any chemical effect. So you can give it to the person and healthy tissue is not affected at all. But inside the cancer cell, there is effectively a pair of scissors that's been created by, built by the genes of the virus, a pair of scissors which can split that prodrug into two fragments. And when that happens, right inside that, the heart of that cell is released a very toxic alkylating agent. It's a chemo which destroys the cell from the inside. And that toxic chemo is being delivered in such a microscopic dose that even if all of it were to leak into the blood, it wouldn't really have any significant effect on the rest of the body. But if an individual cancer cell dies, it sprays not only its neighbors with more virus particles, but also releases molecules of this toxic chemo right in the very heart of that tumor mass, giving an extra killing effect just where you need it. So this is an ingenious technology, a smart technology. It's completely unlike the kinds of cancer chemotherapies that most people with cancer have to take. It can be used almost certainly alongside other kinds of treatments like radiotherapy or traditional chemo or surgery and so on. But it has the power, the potential to transform the way that cancer is managed. Indeed, it is my conviction that oncolytic viruses represent the biggest scientific breakthrough, potentially, that we have seen in the management of cancer for over 30 years.